Hey guys, and welcome to Petrolped, and welcome to this week's Midweek 180. Now, I had a break from the Midweek 180 last week. Two things: I was working away, I was actually delivering my first training course doing my day job, but my first training course in over a year and a half. It was just brilliant being back in the classroom. A little bit weird, but brilliant. But yeah, I wanted to bring you up to speed with some of my FOS content, so I had a bit of a week off, but we are back again and we have much to discuss. If you've not seen one of these before, this is my midweek update where I bring you my news, views and information about upcoming reviews, all filmed in one take. I'm going to put 180 seconds in the bottom left hand corner of your screen, and that's it. A very simple format. Somehow I don't think 180 seconds is going to be long enough this week. But also, before we start, I wanted to point out this. So as you know, I work with my good friends at Control and Shift to bring you a range of Petrolped merch, loads of different t-shirt designs, a couple of hoodies, some mugs, t-shirts, stickers, all kinds of things. But I often get asked, why don't you do a polo shirt? Well, your wish is my command. So we've pulled together this really nice 100% cotton polo shirt. It's in navy blue. The Petrolped logo, that's the first time I put it in that color, and I think it looks really, really smart. But yeah, I'll put all the details in the description below. Head over to controlandshift.com and grab yourself a Petrolped polo shirt. Good way to help me run the channel and support the channel. Anyway, let's get cracking with this week's Midweek 180. I think I'll start my timer. I'm a bit worried. I don't have a great deal of time and lots to talk about, but here we go. Leader of the pack last week was Mark C. Congratulations, sir. Joined in the Magnificent Seven by Colton Cleveringer, Christopher, Paul Mead, Harry Steadman, Keith Evans, and Martin Biswell. Whoever puts the first comment this week, you'll be my leader of the pack next week. And the first seven comments, you'll be in my Magnificent Seven. Where are you and what you're doing? Well, that was Footy Seven, who was enjoying some cottage time by a lake in Canada. That just sounded lovely. But wherever you are right now and whatever you're doing, put it in the comments below and I'll give you a shout out next week. The question last time was about your Festival of Speed highlights. I didn't get so many of them. What I did get was lots and lots of comments about the Hamilton-Verstappen crash at the Grand Prix race that took place the weekend before. This week's question, I want to know what your favourite engine sound is. Is it an Audi 5-cylinder, a V6, a V8, a V10, W16, flat 6, flat 4? Which is your favourite? I would love to know. I drive a rather special V8 on this Friday's video, and it sounded incredible. F1 from the weekend, Hungarian Grand Prix, oh my goodness me. Bottas outbraked himself on the first corner, set the cat amongst the pigeons, and the rest of the race was just mega. Hamilton made a mistake on tyres, ended up at the back of the grid, fought its way all the way through the front. The Alpines were amazing. Ocon wins his first race. Verstappen is out. Vettel comes second, then gets disqualified for not enough fuel in the car. Incredible. Absolutely incredible race. RS3 broke the Nordschleife record for compact class this week with a lap time of 7 minutes 40. Unbelievable. Can't wait to drive that car. But I wanted to talk to you about fuel. Now, in the UK, we are about to get a new fuel designation called E10 from September. Now, this is the biggest change since we basically banned leaded fuel back in 2000. Now, we've had E5 petrol since 2019. The 5 basically refers to 5% of the petrol being bioethanol. E10, no surprise, 10% of it will be bioethanol. And the idea behind it is that will reduce CO2 emissions for the country around about 750 tons of reduction in a year. That's equivalent to taking 350,000 cars off the road, by the way. So that's why we're doing it. What's the problem? Classic cars are the problem, because the ethanol part of it is firstly hygroscopic. What that means is it absorbs water. And that means we can get condensation building up in fuel tanks, fuel lines, carburetors. And in older cars, they're often made of metal and you can get corrosion problems. And then the other problem is ethanol is a solvent and it eats things like rubber and plastic and fiberglass. And you get those in classic cars. So basically, if you've got an older car, basically anything made before about 2002, and that's about 600,000 cars, that is a big problem. And the big challenge is what impact that's going to have on those classic cars. There are a couple of other issues as well. First of all, the issue is I've just ran out of time. The other issue, and this is quite interesting, is it's not as energy dense as the E5 petrol or normal unleaded. So what that actually means is you're not going to get the same kind of fuel economy. So you're going to actually use more fuel, which isn't so good. And that's a big challenge. So I'd love to know what you think about it. Do you own a classic car? Are you worried about the move to E10 petrol? Your short-term fix is to use super unleaded petrol, although that's much, much more expensive, because that doesn't change to E10 for another 5 years. So that's your kind of five-year get-out plan, but it's a big problem. And you can adapt cars by removing rubber fuel lines or fiberglass petrol tanks or whatever it might be, but it's a really big problem. There's lots of articles, lots of things out there. I mean, would you like me to do a longer video on it? Because I think it's a subject that probably warrants a video of its own right. But yeah, really, really interesting. I'd love to know your thoughts on it. Anyway, this Friday's video at 6 o'clock. I know I'm out of time. Sorry about that one. I knew I would be. When I drove the GT40, which was last Friday's video, which has gone down really well, what an epic car that was. After I'd driven that, it was one of those pinch me kind of days, I then got to drive a Mark III Superformance Cobra. And that's a Cobra that's been sanctioned by Carroll Shelby himself. So it's it's a resto mod, basically. Amazing car. It's got the modern day 5-litre V8 Coyote Ford engine that you find in the new Mustang. Straight pipe, side exit exhausts, just an utterly sensational car. I mean, amazing performance, 450 odd horsepower, but the noise it made, oh my God, the noise. It's the best sounding car I've ever driven, without question. Amazing thing. So you need to tune in on Friday at 6 for that one. But I am waffling. Please let me know what you think about E10 petrol. Head over to Corolla Shift to buy yourself a new petrol ped polo shirt, because I think they look rather smart. But on that one, I shall call it a day. I hope you enjoyed that one. If you have done so, please give me a thumbs up. Comments below are always welcome. And if you haven't done so already, please subscribe to Petrolped for plenty more content to come. And I'll see you on the next film, which is this Friday at 6 o'clock for the Mark III Superformance Cobra, sanctioned by Carroll Shelby himself. An utterly incredible car. Looks like Batman's daily, sounds like thunder. Don't want to miss that one. I'll see you on that film, guys. You take care. Drive safe.